Welcome to Institute of Quality and Reliability. Hi, this is Hemant.
We recommend that viewers should see our previous three videos before watching this video. DOE 1 was about introduction to the design of experiments. In DOE 2, we explained a case study in application of design of experiment to spot welding process. And in DOE 3, we discussed about converting coded and uncoded data and establishing regression equation. In this video, we will discuss case study in application of design of experiments to maximize fatigue strength of crankshaft. We will illustrate use of Minitab software to create and analyze the design. There are three factors and each factor is at two levels. Thus, single replicate of the experiment will have 8 trials or runs. As you can see from the experimental matrix, for each of the factor, half the runs are at low level and half the remaining runs are at high level. Let us now create design in Minitab software. I am using Minitab 19 version, but commands will be similar on previous versions. So we use the stat DOE command. So stat DOE, you will see various options, screening, factorial, response surface, etc. We choose the factorial and in that we choose the create factorial design as shown here. In the create design, again, we have 5 options, 2 level factorial, default generator, then specify generator, hard to change factors, etc. We choose the 2 level default generator. In the number of factors, we can choose 2 to 15. We choose 3 as we have 3 factors. Now we just click on the display design for information. Now this dialog box shows the available designs in Minitab software. The number of factors in the top row 2 to 15 and the number of runs on the in the column. We have 3 factors, so we have 2 possible designs with 4 runs and 8 runs. On the lower side, we have Plackett-Berman designs. So we click on the designs, we see those 2 options, half fraction and full factorial. So we choose full factorial. In the number of center points per block, we can choose 1 or more center points, but here we don't have center points, we choose 0. In the replicates, we choose 3 because we have 3 replicates in 3 different batches. And the number of blocks is also 3, so we choose 3 blocks. Now we choose the factors. In the factors, we specify the values of factors, sometimes called properties of the factors. So the first factor is radius, type is either numeric or text. We choose numeric. Low value is 6, high is 8. The second factor is surface roughness. We call it roughness. It's again a numeric factor. So we choose numeric and the low is 0.2 and high is 0.4. The factor C is case depth, again a numeric factor. Low is 1 millimeter and high is 2 millimeters. So we click OK after specifying the factor levels or factor properties. So after clicking OK, we go back to the original dialog box of creating design. Now we click on the options dialog box. We have some options related to folding designs, which we will not see right now. But an important option is to randomize runs, and we must keep it intact that it checked.
Randomization is necessary to minimize effect of unknown and uncontrolled noise factors.
We also leave the default option of store design in the worksheet. And in the results, we leave the default options, but it allows you to choose either default interactions or interactions through particular order. We leave it at default and click OK to create our design in Minitab. So now Minitab has created the design. There are 3 factors with base design 3x8, that is 3 factors, 8 runs, 2 to the power 3 design, and 24 runs, replicate 3. Blocks 3, center points total 0, and block generators, replicates, all terms are free from aliasing.
Click on View Data Only to see the worksheet as shown here. Now we see the worksheet. Run order is the randomized sequence in which we should run the experimental treatments. Standard order is the sequence in which experimental design is structured. It is also called Yates order. In center point column, each row has a code. 1 indicates a corner point from the design, while as 0 indicates center point. In this design, there is no center point, so all rows have got code equal to 1. The blocks column shows block number for each row or treatment. In this experiment, there are 3 blocks. These 3 columns show settings or levels of the factors for the treatment in that row. The design matrix is displayed in the sequence of run order. We can use stat DOE display design command to choose display design in standard order. Now you need to enter the data of the 3 replicates. Data is available from the download section of our website as shown here. Now let us add the response column to the worksheet. For convenience, we can copy and paste the data of response strength from the Excel worksheet as shown here. The Excel worksheet has the design matrix stored in the standard order. Copy the data from column strength from Excel and paste it in MinuteAb worksheet as shown here. The factor level values are currently displayed in uncoded units. We can also choose to display these in coded units. We can use the command stat DOE display design and choose coded units to display this in coded. Now you will see -1 and +1 convention in the 3 columns of radius, roughness and case depth. Thus, we have successfully created the required design in MinuteAb software. We will see how to analyze this design in our next video. Thanks for watching this video. Hope you found it worth watching. Please subscribe to Institute of Quality and Reliability channel if you want to watch more videos on Reliability Engineering, Six Sigma and Statistical Quality Control. Click on the subscribe and bell button to get notified about our new videos.